like problems lots and lots of times.
Like what?
Like killing each other. You'll be a gang. I mean this. You're a gang. You're the boss. Get angry with this guy. Suddenly you shoot him. It's a heavy gun. You know what? Real big gun, it's real heavy. You can just look at it and say, oh, no, that gun's not heavy. And when you carry it, you'll hear how heavy it is. I carried a big gun, I carried an AK-47.
In this film, we meet 7-year-old children living in South Africa in 1992. In many ways, they're just like children anywhere, but they have been born into a time of violent conflict. This is Andiswa, finishing off her breakfast before she goes to school. Her best friend is Leander. Andiswa and Leander both live in this hostel in a township outside Cape Town. Their families each live in one small room off this shared living space. This film shows you South Africa today through the eyes of its 7-year-olds. Their lives and views are both reflections of the past and indicators for the future. The children you will meet come from all over the country. Every 7 years, we'll meet them again, and we'll see how they've got on. Now, like Andiswa, they are all 7, but they have little else in common. This is Artie's favorite song. Artie is the baby of her family and the apple of her father's eye. At home, her constant companion is Chantel, the maid's daughter.
My mother works with my father. She doesn't hit me, she doesn't shout me. She buys me everything and they spoil me too much.
So do you think you've spoiled?
Yes. My father, he likes me, he goes and gets me toys, he's not strict. Sometimes, they buy me all the toys. He takes me for lunch.
And what do you do when you get home?
I play. I go running.
Do you run by yourself?
No. I ran with the maid's daughter.
With Chantel?
Yes.
And where do you run to?
Just around the house.
This is Linda. He lives with a great aunt here in rural Transkei. His parents live over 600 miles away in Cape Town. Linda hasn't seen his mother for over a year. This is Lunga Street in a township near Durban. Lunga lives with his mother and uncles in a small house next to the cemetery. He goes to a mixed-race government school in a white Durban suburb.
Lunga, who's buried here?
My granny.
Did you know your granny?
Yeah, I knew her.
Tell us about her.
My granny was sick when she died. Died at hospital.
But now, what do you think has happened to her?
There's nothing under here.
So where's your gran?
My granny's became bones.
Show us where your house is.
My house is down there. You see where those holes are? You go up and you get out of there. That's where my house is.
Do you worry about ghosts?
No, not at all.
Linda did not go to Cape Town with his parents because they wanted him to attend school here in rural Transkei. As they don't have a uniform, everyone dresses up in their best clothes to go to school. Artie's school is in the old Indian trading district of Durban. The school has been Indian for generations. In the past, this meant that only Indian children could come here, but now the school is allowed to accept any child, whether they be black, white, Indian, or what is known in South Africa as coloured. Claudia and Shane would have been classified as coloured. This mixed-race community was labelled by apartheid as a racial group and was forced to occupy a separate place in society. Claudia and Shane go to school in a coloured area of Johannesburg.
Would you like to go to a school with white children?
I don't know. No. No.
Why not?
Because I like it the way it is. I don't want to go with
Maybe the they speak another language and you ask them for the rubber, they won't know.
Shane, what is the way that it is?
I like it the way that it is. Your friends speak the same language
like
as you do. Your madam speaks the same language. Everybody speaks
and
the same
Afrikaans, language. And Afrikaans, they speak the same language. They understand what they say when they speak Afrikaans.
But we don't.
Lizette is Afrikaans. Like well over half of white South Africans, Afrikaans is her first language. Andiswa counts herself lucky. It is very difficult for hostel children to get a place in any township school, and this is a particularly nice one. This is Willem. He and his brother and sister have the run of their father's farm here in the northern Transvaal.
Jy vriende wat op die plaas bly?
Ja.
Wie soll er?
It's Makanda, Sitain Boy en Willy.
En wat maak julle saam?
Nee, Willy kom vra net elke dag hy oggend die sleutel as ek wakker is. Dan sê ek van goed, hier is die sleutel en dan gaan hy maar weg. Makanda, ons doen baie goed saam.
Soos vertel bietjie soos wat?
Ons partykeer een keer toe ons saam die bosies uitgetrek in die tuin. Ons het saam in rugby gespeel. En ons my sussie loop altyd saam om te tred. En as hy werk, loop sy saam om fiets. Reis op my fiets daar so langsom.
En hoekom hou jy van hom? Hoekom hou jy van hom?
Want hy is 'n baie goeie boy. Hy drink nie.
Franz lives in Alexandra Township on the edge of Johannesburg. Kashan also lives in Johannesburg. She goes to a private progressive school with her friend Nabunya, who lives nearby. Nabunya is unusual in South Africa. Her mother is black and her father is white.
And when you go home, what do?
Nothing. It's boring at home. My two brothers and my sister are pains in the necks.
Why?
Because they expect me to clean the whole house.
Do you have to do errands like that? Do you have to do cleaning and that sort of thing?
Yeah, because I come from Swaziland, and in Swaziland, every little girl my age has to clean.
So what are the things that you have to do?
Have to sweep the floor, everything.
I come home, I play TV games. I sometimes go to extra stuff like swimming
and
tennis. Most of the time I'm at swimming and tennis.
And she always comes home and have some milkshake.
The chocolate milkshake. Because I always have to leave, I always have to go to swimming. After that milkshake, I have to pack my bag, and I have to go to swimming, I have to go to tennis, then I have to come back. I have to do my homework.
So much things.
This is Thembisile. She lives alone with her grandmother in a squatter camp in Soweto outside Johannesburg. Last year, this area was covered with shacks, but most people fled during a bloody war for control of the camp between Nkata and ANC supporters. Thembisile and her grandmother live in one of the few remaining shacks.
Akuthandi la hlala khona le. Akuthandi. wangangithandi ukuzondelayo. Ufuna ukuhlala phi wena?
Tropeni.
Ufuna ukuhlala tropeni? Ufuna ukuhlala noba netropeni?
Amama.
Oh, mama wakho uhlala etropeni? Mama wakho akuhlalela? Wenzani etropeni mama wakho?
Asebenza.
Sebenza kuphi?
Bramfontein.
Ah, umbona nini mama wakho?
Umbona ngamasonto. Sonto.
Oh, ngamasonto. And ubaba?
Baba yena ngikamboni. Ngimbona basedrobheni unani.
Hawu.
This is Bonita, whose father is a Zulu chief in Natal.
Ah, manje lapha. Kwenzakalani?
Ubaba.
Uphi ubaba?
Nanga.
Ubaba uqhokeni?
Wayeqhoke izinto zokuvulula.
Baba, wanilaya.
Yimina.
Nini?
Isimncane.
Ukuphi?
Ngangihlele etafuleni.
Hawu. Shu. Kwenzakalani la?
Ubaba.
Ibe kwenzakalani?
Babehamba babeyokosina.
Yini lenze noba ziphethe lezi?
Iflag.
Yani?
Inkathi.
Because Bonita's father is a chief, their home is a meeting place for elders in the area. Tini is a rugby fanatic and is the smallest player in the under-9 school team. He goes to the same Afrikaans school as Lizette.
Wat is julle gunsteling dinge in die wêreld?
Sit reg op.
Ag ja, ons is so moeg.
Ek gaan van die bank af terug, joh.
Maak jy nie.
Nou dat dan. Oei, gaan ek weer.
Julle gunsteling dinge?
Ja, ek het 'n verhouding met haar.
Shoo.
Tini and Lizette have been going steady since nursery school.
Wat beteken 'n keis?
Shoo. Vra vir hom, hy sal meer weet.
Hoekom het julle mekaar gekies?
Omdat hy mooi is.
Dis hier, like, daai tuiklap.
En waar is dit? Ek gee jou 'n tuiklap op jou oor.
Ah, nee!
Tell me about her.
Her name is Kim. I told you about her last time. I had 2 girlfriends. Kim and Lauren, now I got 1.
What happened to Lauren?
She went to boarding school. On the holidays.
And what do you and Kim do together?
Spend a lot of time.
Do you have boyfriends?
No.
Why not?
Because. Oh yeah, I know what boyfriends are. The boys.
As in French.
Yeah.
Yeah. I had one.
I thought you meant.
Yes, I know.
What?
Like. You hang around with them all the time, go parties with them. No, I don't do that.
Why not?
I'm too young. When I'm about
14, 15,
20. Now I'm first getting married, then, because I'll get AIDS. I think of that. My mother did that.
What?
She first got married.
Do you want to get married when you grow up? Why?
Because I must.
You don't have to get married if you don't want to get married, Chang. It's up to you. It's not up to your mother. If you want to get, if you meet a girl and you like her and you want to marry her, get married. And if you don't want to, don't.
And then yourself?
Don't force yourself.
And yourself, do you want to get married?
No.
Why do you want to get married?
No, 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 no.
I'm a great musician, all of you will say that. And then the boys say their part and the girls say their part, right?
Yes. I'm a great musician. What can you play? The piano, piano, piano. The piano, the piano.
South Africa's school system divided children up according to their official race. Now policy is changing and government schools are becoming mixed, but for the most part, separateness is still the norm. White private schools have welcomed black children for many years, but the fees are totally out of reach for most black parents. This is Katlego. He lives in Soweto and attends this exclusive boys' school in Johannesburg.
I have no friends. If I were a bird, I'd have lots. I'd fly away up in the sky, and my friends would fly with me. I have no friends. If I were a fish, I'd swim all day in a pool, and my friends would swim with me. If only I could fly without wings, and if I could swim without needing to breathe, I'd have lots and lots and lots of friends, because they'd all play with me. You can have friends whenever you want by being just what you are. Don't bother about the brother who bugs you. Just love him and he'll love you too. The end.
This is a typical township school. This is Tsepo. He lives in Soweto and takes his studies very seriously. Not all children in South Africa go to school. At Andiswa and Leander's hostel near Cape Town, Leander spends the morning playing football in the central courtyard with his other friends. This hostel where he lives is for migrant laborers. Leander is from Transkei and doesn't go to school in the township because he is waiting to move back there. This is an English lesson in Andiswa's classroom. English and Afrikaans are still the only official languages here, although most South Africans have other languages as their mother tongue.
This is a book.
This is a book.
This is a book.
This is a book.
Xhosa.
Hayi ba ngixhosa wena. Kuba kuthini?
Ngoba kuthini?
Awuhaleli tuba ngulungu. Ngoba?
Ngoba loko angifuni ukwazi ukhumisha.
Awufuni ukwazi wena ukhumisha.
Oh, bananxosi xa ubuzwa phaa ngumiswa uzawubuthetha into yakho.
Wona onagana gore o ka ithuta English. Wa rata o ithuta English. Ke ka baka lang gore o ithuta English.
O tlo bua monate, wa thuba go galla.
What languages do you speak?
Sete, but I don't really know it very well.
Do you know English better?
Because every time I always speak English, that's why I don't even know my language properly.
How do you feel about that?
All right.
I will now weet wat is die beste taal om te praat?
Afrikaans.
Stem saam.
Hoekom?
Gelukkig verstaan met daardie taal.
Why, Angela, when I want to eat liminal kuluma in?
It's a zool.
Eliminal kawang with the abandu bamshaba wong of an abal kulumi in.
It's a zool.
Njani ngala mapoti?
Kuyaphekwa ngawo noma kupheka inyama noma mhlambe kupheka inyama eningi.
Kupheka ubani?
Oh, mama nje mhlambe bafikile la ekhaya. Mhlambe kumsebenzi uzohlatsha inkomo.
Umsebenzi wabafazi, yini umsebenzi wabafazi?
Ukulima.
Futhi?
Ukulima ushanele igceke, upheke. Bongabu nesitole unyeko sitole, bongabu udayise noma ama-apple noma ubanana, wonke ama-fruits uhambe uyowadayisa.
Umsebenzi wamadoda wona? Yini?
Bongabu inkosi uyasiphatha isizwe, bongabe kuyindoda. Noma buya mhlawumbe uyindoda, omunye afikele umusi wakhe.
Angibona uyiphatha kanjani, asibonise.
Ziphathwa kanjani?
And then leya?
Leya iphathwa ngesandla esisodwa.
Ayi, siwashaya-ke.
Ya?
Siwashaya umuntu-ke.
Bangabe mhlawumbe umuntu ekushaya. Mhlawumbe uthi uyakushaya, mhlawumbe ukushaya lana. Uyibike kanje uzoshaya.
Awu!
When Andiswa gets back from school, she and Leander play around the hostel. Leander is set on going back home to the trans guy. We asked him why he wanted to leave. This is Patrick, who lives a few miles away from Andiswa and Leander. For 5 years now, Patrick has been best friends with Robbie, who lives nearby and goes to the same private school in Cape Town.
What do you want to do when you grow up?
Oh, that. I know. Oh, I'm not really so sure, actually. There are a number of things to choose.
Like what?
fishing.
I want to
engineer,
be a
soccer
lawyer,
player.
A soccer player. I knew I would say that. My big mouth. My dad says I should be an advocate. What do you think?
It would work.
Say for me, what gaan je word as jy groot is?
Soos ek nou dink, ek gaan 'n polisieman word of ek gaan in die bosveld bly.
En as jy nou besluit om in die bosveld te bly, wat gaan jy dan maak as jy daar is?
Ek gaan ouens wat wil kom jag kan by my plaas kom jag en vir 'n bok kry mens mos geld. Want hy skiet mos die bok, dan sit sy bok en dan moet hy vir jou geld gee. Want dis jou bokke.
A beautician. Why do you want to be a beautician?
I don't know. I just like it. Maybe I'll be a singer, a dancer, other things. A doctor.
I don't know what I want to be.
She's going to be a zookeeper.
I don't know. I don't know. Because I love animals.
So now, why do you've got so much animals?
Most of them are mine. The budgie and the one dog and the one cat are mine.
Do you look after them?
Yeah.
Lisette's ambition is to sing on television. She's also just started modeling lessons in the local hall.
But I can't be late, cause then I guess I just won't get paid. These are the days when you wish your babe was already made. It's just another manic Monday. I wish it was Sunday.
Wat doen julle as julle daar is?
Ons loop modelwerk en alles en ons doen ander soorte van die model se loop.
Wat is modelwerk?
Jy sal leer by jou suster. En gou ook.
That's my fun day. Just another manic Monday.
This is Owetu's home. Owetu's father is a corporal in the army of one of South Africa's black homelands. Owetu is very house proud.
Senza
Als jullie nou groot is en jullie moet geld verdienen, zal geld voor jullie belangrijk wees?
Niet voor mij, baie nie.
Is jullie ouders rijk of arm?
Ons is beetje meer arm.
Is dit?
En my pa's die geld is amper klaar.
Hoekom is dit so?
Chocolate seker.
Is die werkse stories.
Maar vertel bietjie vir ons.
Hy moet die spartes betaal, baie keer dan kry hy geld, baie keer moet hy van sy eies gebruik.
Robbie, do you think your parents are rich or poor?
Middle-ish. Sort of rich, sort of poor.
Mine are rich.
Do you think that most children are like you?
Yes. Most children are like me, I'm sure.
Yeah, because you're the goody-goody.
Where Linda lives in the Transkei, the family's wealth is cattle.
What do you think the biggest problem is in South Africa?
There's darkness.
There's?
Darkness.
Tell me about darkness.
It's fighting everywhere.
Who is it that's fighting?
Especially the IFP and ANC.
Hostels like this one play a key role in the war that is going on in South Africa. They have become strongholds for the IFP, the Inkatha Freedom Party. This is Alexandra Township, principally ANC supporting. Alexandra has seen some of the worst clashes between township residents and hostel dwellers. People are divided as to who their leader is.
Dr.
Putilizi.
Start with a M, why don't you take this?
Start with a M.
M.
With an M.
And an A.
And an A.
M A.
You tell me.
And then at the nearly end it's a D.
So you mean Mandela?
Wie is die belangrijkste mens in Suid-Afrika?
Ik weet het Clark.
Ja. France in Alexandra.
Kublavat. Namara nakrat.
Ke mo ba thaba tshwenya mo South Africa man.
Kimkat. Bare tshwenya.
Waita.
Moro bola ya ra sa phela mnate.
Tembesile in Soweto.
Kukubi. Angitshela ukubi kanjani?
Bulalwana.
Wenzani?
Yabulwana.
Babulalwana? Bobani?
Banpenkata.
Babulalwana?
abantu.
Hawu, wabonile bona wena. Nini?
Kana wabona lokwela nomunye wathe phezulu.
What do you think they're fighting about?
I don't know.
And what do you think we can do to stop it?
I think we'll have to pray and tell us God.
Do you believe in God?
Yeah. Do you?
The Dutch Reformed Church plays an important part in Willem's life. He goes to church every Sunday in the nearest town.
Sê vir my, wie is God?
Hy is Here. Hy is ons Vader.
En wat doen hy?
Hy sorg vir ons.
Hoe sorg hy vir ons?
Om vir ons kos en klere te gee.
Is jy bang vir hom?
Nee.
Hoekom?
Want hy maak nie lelik met my nie.
Is jy 'n goeie seun?
Ja.
Wat moet met mense gebeur wat slegte dinge doen?
Hulle moet ophou daarmee en hulle moet vir die Here jammer sê.
She's half Jewish, honey.
I'm half Jewish.
Are you actually? No, did you turn half Jewish?
Yes, I'm half Jewish.
The Zionist Christian Church has the largest congregation in South Africa. France is a Zionist.
Dan steel hulle al hulle goederes, ons hulle weer arm. En wat het hulle toe gedoen?
Hulle het die koring in die skere van die rotse gaan wegsteek.
Dis reg. Hulle het in die skere van die rotse gaan wegsteek aan hulle dagplan en in die berge het hulle dale gemaak.
Wanneer gaan hulle gaan? Moet hy impotente mos uit Afrika kom.
Kom die.
Kom die.
Lema kom.
Is daar swart kinders in jou skool al?
Nee. Hulle kom 1 Augustus na skool in. Maar voor skool. In skooltyd tot eerste pouse. As ons swart is, na eerste pouse is ons niks.
Hoekom?
Want ons gaan hulle doodslaan.
Hoekom?
Hulle mag nie in skool wees nie.
Hoekom?
Want ons hou nie van hulle nie. Hulle mag nie in ons skool kom nie. Hulle is nie wit mense nie. Hulle praat dan swart taal. Hoe kan ons verstaan?
Maar as hulle dan Afrikaans praat?
Dan gaan hulle ook nie. Klere, hulle stink.
We'll be right back.
difference is between black people and white people.
They haven't got the same skin. I think that's all I could say.
Will all South Africa's children get to like each other when they know one another better? Or will the people remain divided? In 7 years, when these children are all 14, we will be returning to find out what life is like for them in the new South Africa.
Argument with this guy and he said he's gonna beat me up.
Now there's been numerous relationships.
Can you tell me when the divorce happened?